The impact of the virus also being felt on the OSU campus. Positivity rates are on the rise, and some students are concerned tonight. Mary Smith is on campus with that side of the story. And all of this coming as Monday, Columbus Mayor Andrew Ginther is coming together with the city attorney as well as the mayor of Dayton to announce a major effort aimed at fighting gun violence. All of it, an effort to save lives. And the football fever will have a top 10 matchup in the Shoe on Saturday. Number 3 OSU to take on number 10 Indiana at home. Now the coach is out with their top 10. All right, turning now to the wicked weather that hit the area this afternoon. The rough and windy conditions impacting communities all across Central Ohio. Throughout the afternoon, viewers and members of the team here sending in countless pictures and videos of what they were seeing in their neighborhoods. Tonight, bars and restaurants across the city saw plenty of customers, folks trying to get out and about before any possible shutdowns. Mary Smith in the Short North Forest tonight with that side of the story. Tonight, as we get set to honor and celebrate the country's veterans, one family is hoping to send out a very special thank you. Brad Underwood has the story. Developing tonight, the fight for the White House is far from over. Joe Biden speaking to the nation last night about his plans moving forward. But tonight, President Trump is not giving up hope. James Rosen has the very latest. We all know the lifeblood of any great program is recruiting, and it's no secret that Ohio State is known for pulling in some of the best young players in the nation. In this week's Spotlight, we're taking a look at a big-time defensive back who could be landing in Columbus pretty soon, and a big-shot tight end who's already committed to playing in the Shoe. All right, turning back to the forecast, Caroline, I tell you what a difference a week makes. This time last week, it was feeling like spring. Tonight, not so much.
Yeah, it's going to be one of those gloomy movie day Sundays. Mm-hmm. It's
not too bad, though, I guess.
Yeah, I guess all things considered, it'll be okay.
We all know this game has what you call an interesting twist. Rutgers is led by head coach Greg Schiano, who was OSU's assistant head coach and defensive coordinator for 3 seasons under Urban Meyer. Now, when Ryan Day got the job, one of the first moves was giving Schiano the boot. That will probably serve as a bit of extra motivation for a Rutgers team that's already off to a pretty good start. Developing at this hour, a soldier from right here in Ohio killed in a helicopter crash in Egypt. We're learning tonight that Kyle McKee was on a peacekeeping mission. Tonight, he's being remembered for his service. It's time to head back to the classroom with Professor Ben, the important lessons that he says we all need to know ahead of tonight's game. Plus, sharpshooter Kim Atkinson taking shots at Nick Foligno this week as he gets ready to pick this week's games. We'll see if he's able to beat the captain. Tonight, it's the small business owners who say they're really feeling the impact of this. They say they've done everything that was required of them and followed all the protocols. Plain and simple, they say another shutdown would put them out of business.
My first feeling was fear. I didn't have a thought. I was just honestly terrified.
Shante Green says this year has been a struggle, but the owner of Beyond the Bricks has fought to keep her Parsons Avenue bar and restaurant going.
I was really shocked to hear that once again our businesses are in jeopardy.
Green says, like countless business owners across the state, since COVID protocols went into place, she's followed all the rules, from requiring face coverings to social distancing and limited hours of operation.
At some point, you know, everyone has to take responsibility for themselves and their safety.
Tonight, despair. She watched the governor's address to the state Wednesday, listening closely to the warning. If the COVID numbers don't drop, businesses like hers will be forced to close once again.
You can't regulate everyone's lives. It's just impossible for people to survive that way.
Green fears the writing is already on the wall, but stresses the governor should know what he's doing to hardworking business owners and thousands of workers across the state.
You know, we all want to be safe and we want to be alive, but we also want to be able to survive.
The official word from the governor is expected this time next week. Until then, Green is simply hoping for the best, but getting prepared for the worst. Rodney Dunnigan, ABC 6 News. There's a fear among some bar and restaurant owners that people will look to pack in this weekend, thinking it will be their last weekend of fun. And many are being proactive in efforts to heed the governor's warning about another possible closure.
The Little Rock Bar near Italian Village, a pretty popular spot. Management here believes in keeping customers safe.
Everybody that comes in here feels pretty comfortable.
Following the governor's warning this week that another business shutdown could be ahead if COVID numbers don't drop, local establishments establishments like this one taking quick action.
In the more dramatic measure that we're taking is no indoor seating, and then we're constantly wiping down tables with sanitizer. There's hand sanitizer in probably 20 different places in the bar. You know, we don't let anybody in the building except to grab drinks and use the facilities, so we're being pretty cautious.
Friday morning, a cleaning crew in doing a massive COVID spray.
What the business owners need to do is be ahead of the game.
This, an effort to make sure the building is clean and germ-free.
If we're coming in at least once a week, it's definitely lowering your risk.
Also, clear reminders about face coverings. Businesses across the state have less than a week now to help make a dent in the problem.
Everybody's rent's coming due and a bunch of people's unemployment's about to run out, so I'm definitely concerned for the staff.
Business owners hope the measures they're taking now will not only be enough to stop the spread and keep those numbers down, but also keep their doors open. Rodney Dunnigan, ABC 6 News. The big focus this week has been on the state curfew. It goes into effect Thursday night at 10 and will run for 21 days. State leaders say the ultimate goal is to keep people from gathering.
The virus spreads when people get together. So for a while, we need to make sure that fewer people are coming together and spreading the virus.
Starting tomorrow, that means a curfew from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. statewide. Doctors stress now is the time to take these measures in efforts to stop the spread.
We are in a very precarious situation.
Since the announcement, viewers contacting ABC 6 with a number of important questions. Who will enforce the curfew? Will people out after 10 be arrested? What if I work overnights? The governor says a lot of it boils down to common sense.
There's always emergency. And there's always some exceptions, but all retail closed by 10 o'clock.
Here are some very important things to remember. This doesn't apply to commuting to work, medical emergencies, and food delivery, just to name a few things. Enforcement will be up to local police and health departments, but the governor doesn't expect citizens out after 10 to be getting pulled over. The thought is these measures will keep people safe and keep businesses open, but it's no guarantee.
If we could all do these things, we will avoid shutdowns, but no one can predict the future.
Starting Thursday night, it's simply a waiting game to see if these measures work and what things may look like across the state in a few weeks. Rodney Dunnigan, ABC 6 News.